Good morning, everyone. So we have seen the unit number two. So in the previous lectures, so whatever the theory of the unit number two, so that we have seen in the previous lecture. So today we shall see the what are the problems that is required to remember to solve the problems. So afterwards, so we shall go and see the problems. First of all, so I will show you the different type of problems formulas, so that we need to remember. So already I explained in the theory during theory. So we have seen this, all these things, variables, causes, population, sample, and random variable. So we need to remember, so what is meaning of arithmetic, mean, median, and mode. So we need to remember these formulas. So what is formula of mu? So that is arithmetic mean. So that is given by the summation of f of I into xi divided by summation of fi. So this formula is important. So otherwise you can use in the form of this summation of fi, means it is a total number of population. So otherwise you can say observations. So afterwards it is a mean. So afterwards it is a, that formula mu is, you need to understand, you need to remember. So afterwards you need to remember the this standard deviation formula, that is sigma is equal to summation of square root of summation of fi xi square minus, so this summation of fi xi whole square by n. So this is whole square, so n ko square nahi, so that whole square divided by n, so whole divided by n minus 1. So this is standard deviation formula, so you need to remember this. So afterwards you need to remember the coefficient of variation, c is equal to so sigma by mu. So you may also get the this to find the coefficient of variation for the, so in case of MCQs, so MCQs may be aapko question aa sakta hai iske upar. So afterwards, okay, so for next thing is, so you need to understand what is meaning of reliability. So reliability is very important parameter, so that already explained in the previous lectures. Okay, so next is margin of safety. So margin of safety, so this formula is given by the difference between material strength and stress. So jo strength rehta hai material ka, so minus jo stress induce hota hai. So stress induce kab hota hai, when the stress will be induced, so when you apply some force. So when you apply the force, so whatever the resistance it is created from the material side, so that is called the stress. So this should be always greater than zero, so that material, or you can say part, will be in safe condition. Otherwise, so if it go in minus, if it become minus, then so the part will going to fail, so it will not going to sustain the applied loads. So afterwards you need to remember this formula, that is mean, arithmetic mean of the margin of safety is equal to so mu s minus mu sigma, means arithmetic mean of strength minus arithmetic mean of applied stress induced. Same way, so standard deviation of margin of safety, so sigma n is equal to square root of this formula. So these are the formulas you need to remember, so before we are going to solve the problems. So, and also you need to understand this curve. So what is meaning of this curve? So in this curve, so this central line is arithmetic mean. Okay, so y-axis indicates it is frequency. So how many times it is going to occur, and x-axis is, so here it is margin of safety. So in some other cases, so it may be, so observation values. So उसमें प्रॉब्लम के टाइम पे आपको समझ में आ जाएगा क्लियरली. सो सो शैल गो टू द प्रॉब्लम्स. Okay, so problems are simple ones. So it is like addition and subtractions. So apart from that, there is no big things in these problems. Dekho, this is a problem. A batch of 150 case hardened per pinion. So a batch of case hardened per pinion. Case hardened spur pinion are tested for surface hardness. So means it is 150 number of parts are equal to 150. So they are. So what is the man type of process here? So it is case hardened. So there are, this is a type of hardening process. Okay. So it is case hardened spur pinion. So pinion and gear. So already you know that what is meaning of pinion and gear. So आर टेस्टेड फॉर सर्फेस हार्डनेस. उसको क्या किया, सर्फेस हार्डनेस को टेस्टिंग किया बाई यूजिंग विच मेथड, ब्रिनेल हार्डनेस टेस्टिंग मशीन. सो हार्डनेस ऑफ द स्पर गियर पिनियंस आर टेस्टेड बाई यूजिंग द सो ब्रिनेल हार्डनेस टेस्टिंग मशीन. सो हियर इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इज दैट द रिजल्ट आर टेबलेटेड एज फॉलोज. सो जो भी रिजल्ट आया है, सो 150 का, so suppose if you make the addition of number of pinions, isko pura ko ek hai, first column indicates it is Brinell hardness number. So it is a Brinell hardness number. So and second column is number of pinions. So number of pinions, so agar isko sabko add kiya to, so you will total number of pinions are is equal to 150. So this is the number of pinions, means they go Brinell hardness number of 5 pinions is 440. Means kitna hai frequency, kitna hai f is 5. 440 ka frequency kitna hai 5. Next 445 Brinell hardness number, how many gears are having, it is 10. So 445 ka frequency hai 10. So like that. So you can see the different values of hardness number of the gears. So what do we need to find here is, so mean, calculate the mean, the standard deviation of the Brinell hardness number of this example. So here two parameters we need to find. So first one is mean, that is mu, and standard deviation. So half the Brinell hardness number. So two parameters we need to find. So when there is a problem in this type of problem, so first you need to make the thing is, you need to tabulate all the values. So you need to tabulate all the values. So they go first column, whatever the given data, so random variable means, देखो दिस ब्रिनेल हार्डनेस नंबर, सो दिस इज अ वेरिएबल, मींस जो भी मेजरिंग वैल्यू होता है, सो दैट विल बी वेरिएबल्स एंड नंबर्स विल बी, इट इज फ्रीक्वेंसी, सो इट इज एक्स आई एंड दिस अदर नंबर्स आर द एफ आई, मींस दिस इज वेरिएबल दैट इज रैंडम वेरिएबल एंड दिस इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो इफ यू सी द फार्मूला ऑफ म्यू एंड सिग्मा, so first important to know the what is the formula of mu and what is the formula of sigma. mu ko formula so maine earlier shown that mu is equal to summation of fi into xi divided by summation of fi. So summation of fi means it is total number of observations, it is 150. So summation of fi into xi, fi into xi jo multiplication hota hai to uska summation chahiye hamare ko. Okay, so this values we required. So afterwards, so we required fi into xi whole square iska summation. Uske baad, so we also required fi into xi, summation of fi into xi. So iska summation mil gaya to isko hum square karke, so we will get this summation of fi xi whole square. So these parameters we required. So we required fi into xi. So afterwards we required the fi into xi whole square. So isliye kya karne ke dar? So table mein, so you can extend here. So fi into xi. Okay. So dono ko multiply kiya to fi into xi. Dono ko multiply karne ka. 5 into 440 it is 2200. Similarly, so 10 into 445 it is 4450. Similarly, you need to take this summation of fi. Isko sabhi summation kiya to it is 150. So total number of observations. So afterwards, iska summation of fi into xi is. So isko summation kiya to, so you will get the 68325. So afterwards, fi into xi square. Dekho, fi into xi square. So similarly, idhar kya karne ka, fi into xi hai already. So this parameter, this term. So इसको xi से मल्टीप्लाई करने का fi into xi into xi, so you will get the fi into xi square. So ये दोनों को मल्टीप्लाई किया तो 440 into 2200, so you will get the 968000. So like that, so you go on multiply and get the so fi into xi square values. So इसको वापस इसको summation करने का, so you will get the, if you make summation addition of all the values, so you will get the f summation of fi into xi square is equal to 3112 7875. So this is the so different values so that we required, so have been calculated. So we required summation of fi into xi, we required summation of fi into xi square. So these two values we require, so that we have calculated here in this problem. So next step is, so just put that values in the formula, that is mean is equal to summation of fi into xi, it is 68325 divided by summation of fi is 150. So you will get the mean of the observations. So it is equal to, mu is equal to 455.5 BHN. So BHN means it is Brinell hardness number. So it is a number. So hardness values are always expressed in terms of the, so numbers. So Vickers number, Brinell number, Rockwell number. So these are the numbers. So it is hardness has been expressed. Okay. Next is standard deviation. So standard deviation, again, formula is given by, this is formula, so square root of summation of fi into xi square minus summation of xi, fi into xi whole square divided by n whole divided by n minus 1. So you just substitute this. So summation of fi into xi square, so already we have in the table. So 3112 7875. So just to substitute that value. Minus summation of fi into xi. Summation of fi into xi is 68325. So 68325 ko substitute karo. So uska whole square divided by n minus it is 150. Whole divided by 150 minus 1. So this will, if you simplify this, so you will get the square root of 38.18. So standard deviation agar square root se bahar nikala to, so you will get the 6.26 BHN. So standard deviation of the observation is 6.26 BHN. So this is about the problem. So problems are simple, so you just need to know the formula. So if you know the formula, so just only there is a subtraction and addition. There is no much apart from that. So we have calculated the mean, and we have also calculated the standard deviation. So this is about the problem. To find the mu and sigma, that is mean and standard deviation. Okay. So next is problem number two. So it is also same. There is some only slight changes there here. So problem समझ में आया ना सभी को? समझ में आया क्या problem? So can anyone?
हाँ सर.
Okay.
Hello sir.
Yes yes yes.
हाँ सर, जो आपने apex into x1 का square का formula है वो फक्त x x1 स्क्वायर है क्या f1 into x1 स्क्वायर है?
किसमें? कौन सा फॉर्मूला में?
किसमें क्या? लास्ट टेबल और सॉल्यूशन में टेबल दिखाओ सर.
हाँ ये क्या?
नहीं नहीं हाँ ये f(x) into x1 स्क्वायर होल स्क्वायर है क्या into फक्त x1 स्क्वायर है?
नहीं नहीं ओनली x स्क्वायर है होल स्क्वायर नहीं.
ये रैंडम वेरिएबल का x स्क्वायर है क्या?
हाँ रैंडम वैल्यू का एक्स स्क्वायर है, इसका ओनली एफ आई है.
ओके ओके.
ओनली सिंगल होल स्क्वायर नहीं, ओनली एक्स आई का स्क्वायर है.
ओके, मुझे 4440 इनटू स्क्वायर इनटू 5 का 9680
दिस स्क्वायर इनटू 5 दिस आंसर.
हाँ अच्छा ओके ओके सर.
ओके सो और कुछ डाउट्स एनीबॉडी? किसी का और कुछ डाउट्स है?
नो सर.
नो ओके ठीक है. ओके okay, so we shall go to the next problem. A batch of 100 helical springs, helical compression springs are tested for the deflection under the axial load. So if you see that the testing of the springs is done for the deflection, so that is important parameter in case of the springs. So here, so the result are tabulated as follows. So this is the observation, and this is number of springs. So isme dekho deflection of the spring in mm. So 26 to 28 mm. How many springs are having this deflection? That is 2. Okay. So next is 28 to 30. So how many number of springs are having deflection? It is 12. So next, 30 to 32 number of springs having deflection is 50. 32 to 34 it is number of deflection springs are having this deflection is 30. Afterwards, 34 to 36 it is number is 4. So these are the spring deflection values in mm. So it is the numbers. So here what is we need to do is, so if the permissible deflection for the spring is between 29 to 33 mm, means this is the permissible one. So it's a come is ke andar hi hona chahiye. So whatever the deflection, so that should be between 29 to 33 mm. So here determine percentage of springs likely to be rejected. So that we need to determine the percentage of springs so that are likely to be रिजेक्टेड. सो हियर सो एरिया देखो सो स्कापो आप यू शुड नो दिस टेबल सो दैट इज प्रोबेबिलिटी टेबल इन नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. So area below standard normal distribution curve from 0 to z is as follows. So standard normal distribution curve means it is. So इसको आपको समझने की जरूरत है standard normal distribution curve. So in problem this problem I will explain you. So this is a table. So that we are going to refer this table to find the value of area when z is given. So that I will explain here. देखो सो यार ऑब्जर्वेशन पिछले प्रॉब्लम में कैसा था तो देयर इज इसमें क्या है कि इसमें रेंज दी है 26 28 28 टू 30 सो इन केस ऑफ प्रीवियस प्रॉब्लम सो देयर इज ओनली वन वैल्यू सो यू कैन सी सो दिस इज ओनली वन वैल्यू रैंडम वेरिएबल 440 445 450 लाइक दैट सो बट इन दिस केस सो इट इज नॉट इट इज अ रेंज इज गिवन सो इसमें क्या करने का सो यू हैव टू टेक द मिड पॉइंट देखो 26 टू 28 सो इसका मीन क्या होता है सो इट इज 27 टू 30 का 29 सो लाइक दैट 27 29 सो सभी का क्या करने का उसका मीन लेने का उसके बाद फ्रीक्वेंसी वैल्यू तो सेम है 2 12 50 सो व्हाट आर द वैल्यूज ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी 2 12 50 32 4 सो दिस इज द एक्स आई इट इज एफ आई ऑब्जर्वेशंस रैंडम वेरिएबल एंड दिस इज फ्रीक्वेंसी सो दोनों को मल्टीप्लाई किया तो यू विल गेट दी एफ आई इंटू एक्स आई एंड इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई दिस एफ आई इंटू एक्स आई इंटू एक्स आई अगेन सो यू विल गेट दी एफ आई इंटू एक्स आई स्क्वायर सो दिस अगेन इट इज सेम समेशन को फाइंड करो समेशन करो सभी का सो यू विल गेट दी समेशन ऑफ एफ आई इंटू एक्स आई एंड समेशन ऑफ एफ आई इंटू एक्स आई स्क्वायर So afterwards, so what we need to find here is, so we need to understand, so we need to hear them question is somewhat different. So determine the percentage of springs that are likely to be rejected. So kitna percentage of springs reject hota hai, to usko hum find karne ke. Okay. So uska pehle, so you require the mu. So why it is required mu, that we shall see later on. So mu is how to calculate mu. So that we have seen in the previous problem. Summation of fi into xi by summation of fi. So you will get the value of mu. Dekho, units is always, you need to use the unit, that is, which parameters we are making the observations. Dekho, isme deflection is observation. So deflection is, unit is mm. So previous problem, it is hardness value. So that is a number. Okay. So that, depending on that, so you need to mention the units. Afterwards, again, you need to find the standard deviation. So same like previous problem, standard deviation, use formula. So and you will get the 1.586 mm. So isme dekho, so what is the allowable deflection it is given? So it is from, that is 29 to 33. So problem mein kya diya? So allowable deflection is 29 to 33. So allowable deflection is 29 to 33 mm. So if the deflection is so less than 29 and more than 33, so that will be we are going to say the spring is failed. So isme kya karne ka? Standard variable for minimum and maximum deflection. So for minimum deflection, so x1 is equal to 29 mm. So x1 is equal to 29 mm. Then we are going to find the value of z1. So this comes under the probability. So you need to, it is from mathematical terms. So z1 is equal to, this is formula, so x into x minus mu by sigma. So here it is x1 minus mu by sigma. So x1 is 29 minus 31.48. Mu value is 31.48. Sigma value is 1.586. So you will get the value of z1 is equal to minus 1.564. And similarly, for instead of x1, if you substitute x2 here, so you will get the value of z2. Z2 is equal to x2 minus mu by sigma. So x2 value is 33. Okay, so minus mu by sigma value. So you will get the plus 958. So here that values, whatever the z1 and z2 values, so we need to represent in terms of two curves. So that is called normal distribution curve and standard normal distribution curve. Okay, so normal the normal distribution curve, so it is, so you can see, so this is frequency and this is observation. So x-axis represents the observations and y-axis represents the frequency. So central value in case of this curve is arithmetic mean, that is mu, and x1 is 29, so smaller value will be this side and larger value will be this side. This is 29 and this is 33. So you can use the particular scale. So and mark is 29, so that is x1, where it is 32, 33, so that is x2. So and afterwards, whatever the curve you are going to draw, so that is the called the normal distribution curve. So another one is standard normal distribution curve. So here you can see, in case of standard normal distribution curve, so we are going to consider that center value is zero. So this is zero afterwards. So whatever the area covered by this curve, so total area is equal to one. So total area will be equal to one, and 50% on left side and 50% on right side. Means 0.5 area is on left side, 0.5 area is on the right side. And afterwards, so we are going to mark the Z1 and Z2 values. Z1 value is minus 1.564. So left side is minus, right side is plus. So this is Z1 value, minus 1.564, this point. And this is Z2 value, so it is equal to 0.958. So it is a limit. So springs are accepted between this range, minus 1.564 to 0.958. So iska jo bhi area hai, so between from this line to this line, so this is the accepted range. Iske andar jo bhi springs aata hai, usko accept kiya jata hai. So this side and from this line to this side, so they are rejected springs. So you can say, so they are the rejected springs. So you need to remember that total area under this curve is 1, left side is 0.5, right side is 0.5, center value is always taken it as a 0 in case of the standard normal distribution curve. Okay, so this problem mein kya find karne ka hai? Problem mein the springs likely to be rejected, so that we need to calculate those springs that are likely to be, determine the percentage of springs that are likely to be rejected. Okay, so uske liye kya lagta hai humko, so we require the area value from z equal to 0 to z equal to 1.564. so this area is given by that table. Dekho humko area from 0 se lena padta hai. So agar if we require the area of this hatched portion, so uske liye kya karne ka, hum total area is 0.5 इसको माइनस किया तो यू विल गेट दिस रिमेनिंग एरिया. सो जेड वन इज इक्वल टू 1.564. सो 1.564 पे आपको क्या करना पड़ेगा एरिया के लिए, सो यू नीड टू रेफर द टेबल. ओके, सो यू नीड टू रेफर दिस टेबल. So you need to refer this table. Okay. So here, so you can for 1.56. So here it is for 1.5 and 1.6 it is there. So इसको क्या करने का आप? So you need to make the interpolation. तो interpolation करके तो आपको area का value मिल जाता है. तो देखो 1.5 के लिए 0.43 है, 1.6 के लिए 0.4452. So simply you go for the interpolation. So and you will get the value of area for z equal to 1.564. That is the area of this portion from z equal to 0 to z equal to 1.564. Similarly for z2 is equal to, area is given by, again use that table. So you will get the area from this point to this point. So area lene ka time pe, so we don't consider minus sign. Minus sign ke kuch indication nahi hai, area lene ka time pe. So it only indicates it is left side and right side. So once you get the area values, so by interpolation, so you can get the area values from the table. Dekho, percentage of springs likely to be rejected. Percentage of springs likely to be rejected. It is given by. Dekho, maine kya bola hai? So this area is accepted range from this point to this point. Rejected range is, rejected portion is this hatched portion and this hatched portion. So wo kaise milega? Total area is 1 minus this area and this area means 1 minus a1 plus a2 iska dono ka summation karke jo hota hai 1 mein se minus kiya to so you will get the rejected one. So that's why percentage of springs likely to be rejected is 1 minus a1 plus a2. A1 plus a2, so that is you can get interpolation table se interpolation karke aap area ki value le sakte. So into percentage में express करने का तो multiply by 100, 1 minus a1 plus a2, so into 100, so you will get the 22.85%. So that is the percentage of springs that are likely to be rejected. How much percentage it is? 22.85%. Okay, so this is about the problems. So problems are simple one.